people are going a bit more into double edge. And I think, you know, I'm gonna have to wait to see how this lane goes, especially that safe lane for IG. It's a lot of spam. You know, the Ursa, the snap might be under some pressure. Ursa usually does quite well, but I've seen these Rubick Centaurs just tend to bully most carries.
Yeah, that's the thing to me that always feels a little bit weird is you think about Ursa as like this hero that can try and really get like really aggressive early in the lanes against these melee heroes. But a lot of times you don't have the HP pool to actually go in there and make that move happen. Mm-hmm.
And sometimes like you see like a more defensive kind of five hero. This is a very aggressive five. Like you don't really see Snapfire play too often in the five position lately. You've been seeing a lot more as four as.
Good luck, China Captain.
I like it. A lot of respect there from IG.
Definitely. Emo saying that there. And I think that, yeah, this is going to be an interesting one to watch. They're starting double ring of protection on the Centaur, as we've seen with all that changes now, having crazy base regen right now, 9.1 on this hero. And what is it that you like so much about it? Is it just like the sort of the way that it plays? Because for a long time, it felt like you get this blink dagger and you still can't really fight. Like, what's been the thing that people have been doing more now with Centaur that's really been working?
Lane just feels better because the double edge spam. You're able to harass a lot more. Stampede always feels kind of good. It feels like in some games, there's a limited amount of catch. That being said, Mars is one of the best answers. That's what we saw during, not last TI, but the TI before when these two heroes were like in every game. Mm. It was Mars gets picked, Centaur gets picked, and Mars gets picked because you can't run away, right? Yeah. Pop Stampede, you're trapped in the area. But yeah, let's see how it ends up going.
Yeah, it's going the way that they want it to. We saw a lot of movement recently. I mean, I think people come into this one again anticipating LGD is just going to run away with it. And I think that there's something to be said for that. But I'll also mention that IG looked a lot better than we are giving them credit for.
Ooh, nice.
Yeah, good way to do a little interrupt there. They've been looking a lot better than we were sort of seeing through the first couple of games of theirs. They looked like they improved afterwards, and particularly getting that win just the other day.
Yeah, Dust seems to be a little bit more, you know, in the beginning, I feel like he had some of these games where he did throw away some of their lead with just one or two misplays, but he's been kind of cleaning up. His lane has always been good, and then you have to mention Polisil, right? His Earthshaker and stuff like that, he's been absolutely on fire, how much aggression and stuff he's been able to pose. His Rubick also, the Song Steal. Yesterday, I believe it feels like it was 2 days ago, but it was yesterday.
Yeah.
When he played it, he had a great time. So looking also at the reason why they picked the Enigma, I think it's also just, you know, of course to slow down Morphling, but also they wanted to switch these matchups, right? They didn't want two strength versus that Undying. So now having this lane matchup is a lot better in putting the Mars mid.
Well, we can see that already. Emo not doing too terribly up there top. The spam hasn't really started yet.
Yeah.
That's what we're going to need to watch and wait for. But if they can get off to a good early beginning, things could also, you know, carry on from there. But nothing to say. Likely to make some pretty early rotations, I would imagine. Spear back by Dust just to keep him off of them. And still manages to get a lot of those last hits. So Dust holding his own. Again, he was number one rank in China, if I'm not mistaken. Is that correct?
Yeah, he was. I don't know if... let me check really quick for you again. But he was during the... I think about a week and a half ago, he was. So I can check really fast.
I mean, if he's lost it now, that's not a good look, man.
Hey, you know, so these guys are grinders, man. You never know.
True. Things will go crazy pretty quickly. Nice little half pull there from Paulison. And Why You Smile tries to redraw aggro. Looks like he's going to be able to. So not a free one. Back at mid with the bottle in hand, Dust not able to get a refill right away. Obviously, nothing to say is there to be able to go and get some pretty good aggression onto him, too. We'll see if at that 4 minute mark things change around a little bit here, too.
Yeah, looks. I mean, this lane is going to be a bit more of that trade farm for sure. And then, yeah, I think we're probably, yeah, I'm waiting to see those, the tops in rotation, everybody calls it that, those super early moves. Definitely really interesting. Other cool thing about the Primal Beast versus Mars matchup, if he's trampling and you try to spear him, if it's the trees, he cuts the trees before the spear connects. So little small interactions that we'll have to keep eyes on there for that Primal Beast versus Mars.
Yeah, that could definitely pose a little bit of an issue. So just have to get him onto the cliffs instead or you're on arena.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, next round of these coming up. The Courier bringing some boots for the Primal Beast. And yeah, What is it that those rotations are going to be looking to, like, which lane do you think he wants to go for there? Is there one that's, like, slightly easier or that's more high value, more important to shut down early?
Probably just the Ursa. I think the Enigma's already having a bit of a rough time. It's 11 and 8, but look at the last hits on Shiro. I mean, 24 and 6. They're getting so many of these Eidolons with Y.
Yeah, that is.
And the spam up top, Emo, he's already starting to get kind of low. It's starting to begin. He's having to actually bring his own salves out. So this was a little bit of my concern with the Snapfire. The Ursa, as we said, he's this very strong independent laner, but Snap is just... he's just not the best five position. You know, he in the laning phase, he doesn't really pose too much of help to be able to protect. Just the spam immediately continues.
That's more kill potential if they can do it, but LGD doing a good job of never offering that opportunity. And if it is just a matter of trading, they're going to trade more efficiently with the natural regen that's really high there on that Centaur.
Exactly, yeah. You see, like, the Emo's already had to bring a raindrop as well. They've gone through salves, tangos, another raindrop coming out for QYQX. So just anything to try to absorb that constant spam that's going to be coming out from the two of these. Yeah.
Does still have pretty good last hits on Emo. Obviously not as high as the Morphling with those Eidolons. In the mid lane,
he started to pull ahead.
Yeah, Dust tried to get a spear back onto Nothing to Say to the tower, but was just a little bit off the mark on him. And so Nothing to Say gets out of there scot-free.
Yeah, he's literally just trampling every wave at this point now.
Yeah.
So unable to really prevent him from getting all these last hits. It's causing Dust slight issues at top.
There it is. Planet drawing first blood, and giving a Rubick first blood in a game like this is a very scary proposition.
Yeah, I actually love Rubick as four position taking first blood because you get those arcane boots and it just unlocks your hero completely. So it's cool that he is able to get that. And they're not all going for the Ring of Health on the Centaur. They're going for aggression build. He's going for phase boots. So just looking to play super aggro up here.
Can they do anything though? Cookie out, finds him there. Still very tanky. This guy has 9 armor.
Yeah.
They're not going to be an easy kill at all. But QIQX, having gone back to base, has a little bit more regen to bring out for his Ursa.
They will send the... looks like they will send that Centaur back to base, though, perhaps. Yeah, he's got phase boots. He's going to run back quick and reset.
Okay.
So good little aggressive play there from QIQX. Maybe they can punish Planet as well. They do seem a bit too far out of position.
Oh, at the rotation in.
Oh, and TS, he knows.
Yeah, they realize what's happening. Wants to go forward for this one. Jumps
in. Here comes Mars, though.
And the rotation, it's going to bear some fruit. Nothing to say. Ooh, he gets the pulverize, though.
Oh, my God.
Dude, the turn. Nothing to say. Still going to fall. And as Centaur moves back in, the rest of IG going to back out.
They just placed that lane ward 30 seconds ago. QIQX had just put the one up top, so he saw the rotation coming in. Very nicely done.
It's now gets some pretty good pressure onto this bottom tower with the Eidolon split and the catapult there. Hey, we'll have to run it away in a moment here, but we'll keep the catapult alive for a little while too.
Yeah, pretty good. I mean, half damage on tower with your level 5 Eidolons. Pretty sweet. Great rotation though, Dust. Yeah, reading the map.
Jeez.
So much damage.
And it's just about to be off cooldown again, too. Like, that's a crazy ability to just trade with.
Yeah, and if Dust isn't careful also, if he misses his Rebuke or his Spear on NTS, like, they could just set up a kill onto him, too, with the Trample Charge.
Just be careful. Throws out one. Able to break it.
Nice play.
Dust very much living on the edge in that mid lane against the Primal Beast. But so far, at least, you think about how strong that Primal Beast rotation sometimes feel. The fact he got killed up when he went up top, the Mars rotation made that move. I feel like they've dealt with this early aggression pretty well.
Yeah, it's the lane ward, right? That I was mentioning before from Snapfire up top. I just saw him moving, so they just TP'd very quickly on the Mars. And TS, they're double checking the rune. Dust will get lucky.
That's the illusion there. Now, they are running in towards a ward, but looks like...
nice toss.
Why? Gonna get caught there. Pinned to the side. Has the rebuke. Couple more punches, and the Undying is eventually going to go down.
Got the ward.
All right, he got it. He's gonna give up some gold. Yeah. They also lose the Snapfire on the top side of the map, and I think that's going to be the signal Ursa needs to get the hell out of there.
Yeah, and for people not knowing why he did put that up there, you know, Sentry only gives you vision for a small amount of time, so he needed vision to actually up on the high ground to finish off the ward. So, the trade of gold.
I mean, 125 gold for, what was it, 200 or something like that?
For 125 for 133, so okay. about equivalent exchange, not including his death.
Yeah. Oh, he's dead anyways. Right?
Yeah, he's dead anyway. So. Oh, mid.
Nothing to say. Drops it down.
That's a solo kill.
That's a big one. Allison moves in. They managed to find a cookie. The Ava, the toss with the tower. Is it going to be enough damage?
No way.
Oh, my God. He's living. Unbelievable.
The stampede.
Dude, that's crazy.
I Think cannot about believe
how,
it.
How different that looks if your two supports come in and get the experience turn. Oh, man, that's big.
Paulson goes for just getting the maximum damage rather than maximum control, right, for the Avatos combo. But, yeah, not end up being enough. Raindrops, saving lives, and Stampede, of course, too.
Crazy. It does look like Emo, with that Ring of Health, going to be going for that Battle Fury build. Wants to match the tempo, or at least the scaling of the Morphling. We'll see if it ends up working out for them. Has anything in sort of the early start to this changed your opinion of where this game's going to be going?
No, it just feels like too good of a Morphling game. Like the way that they set this up, it still feels phenomenal for PSG.LGD coming out of the lanes. Ursa's been slowed down, Morphling is not, and they have the counters for that last pick Enigma.
Right.
Up top, Emo. He just every time he shows, he eats a double edge and a Fade Bolt. Even though he has a Ring of Health to sustain a little bit, if he eats a second salvo of it, he can likely just die.
He's got to be so careful right there. And just getting denied in his face consistently.
Olsen. His rotation's coming.
Yeah, there's heroes here. And that's going to be an easy one.
Oh, and Eidolons. Nom, nom, nom.
Primal Beast just, like, feels unfairly strong at certain points in the game. You know what I mean? Like, obviously, this hero falls off later, but this movement is crazy.
Yeah, I mean, thank God that they added that, you know, they changed the charge where you can actually stop him. It was pretty ridiculous, the fact that he would just charge through everything, even when he was stunned.
Yeah.
It was a good little balance change that they did put in. But yeah, he does have great kill threat on these side lanes. That's why they went for this pick. Let's see where Dust's next move is. He has a DD. Maybe he can look to find some opportunity here, but it's just being watched. The ward up on that cliff is just watching them kind of pivot back and forth.
Well, I think over the next couple of minutes when this BKB comes out, the avenues of IG's abilities to fight are going to be pretty freaking limited.
Yeah, it's going to be so early too. I see they have stacks for Nothing to Say as well. Takes out a double stack, has another one. And they're going to have Blink also on the Centaur very soon. So pace of the game, it feels like it will start getting accelerated on top of that. They have easier forms of initiation since it's, you know, it's a 3 Centaur compared to a 4 Tiny. Tiny's going to take a lot longer to get toward that Blink Dagger for them to just force engagements.
Yeah, but there is a ton of team fight on the IG lineup too. You know, you've got that Mars, the Enigma. Granted, there is a Rubick in it, but, you know, you have that. And then, of course, Snapfire Ultimate, which is online now, level 6.
Has to just... It's always scary, right? Rubick.
Yep.
If Snap's not all the way downtown, that those kisses will turn against you as well. Rotation.
It's on in. Irving. Nice bottom. Hello, hello.
See you later.
And Pulverize too. Yep. And Dust moving in now. I mean, they're just a little slow on this.
A little bit of a wasted tombstone, at least there for the side of IG. But yeah, Nothing to Say right now, being a real big nuisance for those kills involving him. And that timing for BKB, it's going to be so fast.
God, he is so farmed.
Yeah.
I mean, Jiang Yu on the Centaur is definitely the one that's sort of fallen by the wayside a little bit by virtue of all this space. But, I mean, Nothing to Say. It's pretty impressive what we're seeing him do on this hero.
Mm-hmm. And even though the Centaur is behind on gold, it's effective gold that he's been efficient gold that he's been spending. He has the blink. So, phase boot blink, he's ready to battle.
Dust a little ways away from his blink being completed. Now, they're smoked up as 3. Irving, the one that's walking out in front, and they'll get him with the Malifus, it looks like.
Okay.
Planet steals Avalanche. That's a good steal.
He wants to go in, perhaps, onto Irving. He's thinking about it.
Stun already. Backs away. Avalanche. Mech is popped.
Okay. Keep the Eidolons alive for this push.
Trying to do what they can to it, and... it is going to be a good chunk of damage onto this tower. And while this is happening, Emo is taking Roche.
Oh, that's a bold attempt.
I mean, he needs a little bit of help. And yeah, Dust is going to come on in and secure that they finish this off.
Okay, nice move. I mean, a bit of a distraction play coming out from IG. It looks like now they do know on the side of PSG.LGD, but it's too late.
Well done.
Sneaky by Emo. Force all that reaction mid and then just walk into the pit.
Making really good moves of this one right now, it feels like. And almost done with his Battle Fury. He's been able to keep up about, what, 600 gold behind the Morphling?
Yeah, pretty good. Pre-Battle Fury, right?
Yeah.
But now, nothing to say. He's got BKB. That's one of the faster ones I think I've seen. Level 12 as well. Holy.
He is incredibly farmed at 14 minutes.
They gave him a ton of stacks, to be fair. I've seen like innocent stacking for him. He's been taking pretty much all of them instead of the Morphling. But now, super ready to battle. Now you can't really cancel the charge too easily at all.
There is still one thing that can do it, that black hole. Mm-hmm. Irving showing in mid. Jump in. Stomp is there. Dust.
Oh! Dust! The drive-by catch!
They have it, though. BKB there. Irving a little bit afraid. They already used the Snapfire Kiss Steal for Rubick. And nothing to say. Oh, my God. The kiss is coming from downtown. The stomp again connects. There's the stampede to try and get out of there. Dust is dead. Holy moly.
The dream Rubick game. Yeah, it's you're always going to get kisses if they're not super far away. That's the other thing that Centaur also allows the Rubick to play even better, right?
Oh, yeah.
He can stampede in, get right into vision, find that snap bar to get the steal. It looked flashy, the spear, catching the Primal Beast, but then he's like, BKB.
I mean, that's the thing, is I feel like, you know, if Rubick does go in there and steal, like, this isn't the window where I'm as afraid of Rubick stealing Black Hole, I feel like, because he doesn't have Blink Dagger yet. I was wondering if maybe there was an opportunity there to throw it out and just, like, say, screw it, it's done. But didn't go for it. Can't blame him. It's a scary thing to give up.
Yeah. Oh, he has to catch. Mostly it's the Rubick, of course, but has to also be wary of this, the Primal Beast's mini stuns, right? If he doesn't catch the Pulverize, or catch that Primal Beast during Pulverize, then the Pulverize is going to clip him and stop him instantly. So, IG, though, we'll at least get the tower out of it. But PSG, LGD, they're fighting as four. That's the difference here. Like, Emo's not really showing up too much, but they're taking the battles as four, and it's pretty convincingly.
3,000 gold lead, and with Battle Fury done, feels like still need time before he can really come online and
more stacks.
Be a presence.
Nothing to say, clearing a quad stack ancient.
Oh, dude. Oh my God, he's going to get Aghanim so quickly. What the hell?
A good Aghanim's game, too, for Set Ursa.
Chasing. Oh, one more hit.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God. He went in deep. Pollicent trying to finish it. Dust. Oh, things getting dicey.
Uh-oh.
They burned through the Aegis, though. Find one. And it looks like they're going to end up losing Emo, dude.
Oh, it's such a risky play by Emo.
Yeah, that one hurts. That one hurts a lot. Man.
He tries to get a solo kill, but it's a pretty bold attempt. He doesn't really know where all of LGD was. He gets destroyed. 5k lead now. That morph under no pressure. He got the shift off so quick.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he was never going to die on Shiro there.
Okay, Planet. I think he wants to try to make use of these kisses one more time. Probably wants to look to smoke the Centaur. Still has it for just a small amount of time. I don't want to ping it because I don't want to write in the chat, but I think it's like 25 seconds or something he's got left on it.
Okay.
Oh, Dust, this could be if he just shows himself. They cancel the blink.
He's done. Damn, dude. Double use out of those kisses.
And he's farming with it. Love it.
Yeah.
Efficiency at its finest.
That's what you want to have. Planet, I mean, we said it was set up to be the perfect Rubick game, and he has shown so far everything he needs to. 3-0-3, you know, being involved in the majority of the kills that have been going on here.
And I like the way he does it, too, because Centaur has a bit of a slow animation for the Blink Stomp.
Yep.
He Fade Bolts first, Blink's canceled, Dust is just stuck in no man's land.
Yeah, no way out. Yeah.
Good recognition. And just so many stacks. That's the thing. Again, just Ancient Stack, Hard Camp Stack. He's been doing this the whole... I don't have an amount that he stacked, but I want to say it's like 11 stacks that he's been able to do while being active.
We'll have it at the end of the game. We'll be able to take a look and see. Oh, actually, there we do. Seven stacks.
Seven. So 7-3-3. Even Shiro stacking. Couple, but 10 between the two supports, it's, you know, indicative of their net worth. You see he's got 5k net worth on Rubick on top, so
jeez, he's gonna get above Dust pretty soon.
Yeah,
this game keeps going this way. And again, we talked about like scaling. It's instead of for Primal Beast going for the Aghanims, he's going Saya. You know what the word is.
Saya Conj.
Saya Conj. Get out of here, you
I do that all the time. Yeah, you know what? That's fine. I mean, both items are really good this game, but I think with the way he's snowballing, he's just feeling more damage rather than just playing around those stacks. He's not really getting hit that much. So I just wanted to buff up everything rather than just his uproar. So Blink now on Polison. So Blink Dust, Blink Polison. Can they look to make any aggressive plays though? Because it feels like LGD just dictating all the pace of the game and all their ults are back up. So Stampede at the ready. They're looking to invade.
And in this area, not seeing anybody really. If they take the long way around, they're going to run into the Snapfire. Maybe Dust too.
Shows himself.
Yeah, showing on that lane is kind of rough.
Dust too. Is this Counter-Strike?
Oh, they see it. They have a ward. Get out of here.
I mean, they got another D ward, and they're scanning right on top of him.
Oh. Ooh. Manages to escape. So you can see the amount there that we've been going through at the 20-minute mark now. Roche, what, 2 minutes till it's capable of respawning? I mean, it feels like LG has basically gotten everything that they've wanted out of this so far.
Yep, and they're controlling the map with around this area next, right? So just putting that ward up on the high ground.
Interesting. 55% with a 5k gold lead. Really valuing, I guess, the power of Enigma late game.
I think it's disrespecting the Rubick.
Yeah.
Jeez. Disintegrated.
Oh, man.
Starting to get difficult for them to make any aggressive moves on the map. PSG.LGD are just, they're ready for every single one of them. Polison with his, yeah, he hasn't been able to find anything with the blink. It's always LGD making the first move. Polison. Oh.
Very close there. Ran into a random nothing to say who is coming down bottom.
Look how he's so tanky. How do they actually bring him down? They're going to have Ursa in every single one of the attempts to go for him. And Emo, he's got Blink and Battle Fury, but he's still incredibly vulnerable. If he commits for a kill, he'll probably die afterwards.
Well, and that's the thing too, right? Is like it's sort of like what Sheep was saying, that they're all so tanky going against Ursa, but he can't hit them all. Mm-hmm. They need Irving, it feels like. Oh, God.
They know he's here.
Oh, man. Yeah, and Rubik's right there, so there is nothing to do. Paulison tries to stop it. Avalanche. Now the Stampede. Couple more hits. Irving is in some trouble. Going to die.
And also Paulison.
Oh, my God. Keeps going. Looking for more. This Tiny doesn't have that many places left to go.
He's okay.
Wondering if they're going to run after him with nothing to say.
Oh, but QIQX, Shiro seems to have found himself a free target.
Yeah, they're just dying all over the map right now.
Yeah. And we saw there, nothing to say, had just hit level 15. So Enigma stuns him, clicks Uproar, no more Malphus on top of you. So good talent choice.
Very good stuff.
Kai'Sa Assange done, level 16. Rune was on top though, so not a haste on the Primal Beast.
He's going to go for a chase there onto Dust. Doesn't decide to do it.
But the Morphling game just continues to be absolutely free. Shiro, 302, top of net worth. Same level as his Primal Beast as well. Oh, interesting. He actually bought the shard on the Morphling. Cool. Haven't seen people do that too often. Oh. Yeah.
Oh, my God, dude. Every time he's there for a second, he just gets completely obliterated.
I actually didn't even notice that he was on the sidelines there. Radiance, he didn't even have anybody close. I guess he just got stuck there.
Yeah. He's so close to BKB. Like, it feels like that's kind of what they're waiting for now. They need to get some other, like, way to make these items work. I mean, Enigma has a Lincoln's BKB queued up because he knows that he's got to stop all of this.
But that's a lot of time that they're looking for is Roche. That second rush, it's on the menu for LGD. It's going to die so fast. Tombstone plus Flesh Golem with Shiro beating on it. No way for IG to make it there. Their lineup needs this Roshan for the Ursa to be able to fight since he's
pretty far
behind. Yeah, like he's going to be getting closer towards BKB, but it's coming out quite late as LGD is getting everything on the map.
Waveforms on in. It's going to be the Shard given over to the Centaur. So the double edge. change-ups there as well. God, I just, you know, when you hover over that, you see what could have been the hitch-a-ride ability on the Centaur.
No.
Dare to dream.
If it only was able to pull people out of Black Hole and Chrono Sphere anymore, then maybe. But
all right.
Gone are the days of that, which I think nobody even got to see it in a pro game. So
sad. Planet, over there in the side. Dust.
Again.
Hello. How are you, sir?
I just bullying.
Jiang Yu going to get caught at Dust. Dropped again by Shiro. Did he finish his BKB? Yeah, he at least finishes BKB this time.
Look how late it is. Level 13. Primal Beast, nearly level 17. I mean, they've set up NTS for the most success possible. Same thing for Shiro with all these stacks. Dust hasn't been able to find much of anything. 1-5-1. After that first rotation top, right? That was kind of feels like it was the only move that IG's had that's gone successful for them.
Tough time indeed. They have the four staff coming out soon here. I mean, it's just, and that was all again set up by that ward, I guess, as well.
Just not even one step ahead, right? PSG.LGD feels like they're three or four steps ahead in this game, not giving any breathing room to IG whatsoever.
Hero starting to take down this top tier two tower while the other side of the map, IG inhabiting that jungle. They claim one of their own, so getting that outpost there. And maybe gonna make something happen mid. You see a ward placed down over on the mini map on behind the tier two tower on the Radiant side. I don't know if that's gonna.
So deep.
I mean, they're at least shooting for the stars. They're like, maybe if we get down here, this is gonna be the big play we can make.
Maybe trying to just read smoke movements and stuff too that's coming out from deep. I'm not sure. Very aggressive ward placed. Dire's top tower is under attack.
But very much struggling to find anything in this game now.
Anything indeed, yeah. Three tanky cores, can't find targets. Now they're just kind of like cutting creep waves and trying to find anything tricky. I mean, Polison's literally cutting waves mid. So I guess that's the purpose of that ward, to delay.
Right. Dire's middle tower is under attack. And I will say that, like, you know, the lead has not ballooned completely in the way that it has for some other ones. 7K, it's remained consistent over the last couple of minutes at least. But can they ever make it really pull back?
And the issue is also, like, they have the Ursa versus Morphling. So you want to be the ones actually with that lead rather than the opposite, because Morphling's just going to be able to scale way harder than that Ursa.
Dust heading out. Oh, finds everybody. The lift is there. BKB.
To him on high ground.
Okay. Emo comes on in, and with the Snapfire, they're going to bring down the Tombstone. Nothing to say. On top of Emo, though, BKB wearing out low. He pig pulls to run away. Try and reset on the fight. Stolen Arena. That, I'm not sure what that was.
It looks cool.
Okay.
He's like, this area is ours. I tried to catch the Enigma, but quick blink from the Enigma to get out.
Okay. I was confused why he stopped the Pulverize on the Primal Beast.
On the Ursa?
Yeah.
He had Enrage on.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
there
it was just 80. Yeah, it was just reduced all the way down, 50%.
27 minutes, and again, these fights don't look completely terrible. It's not great, but.
They're having to get a kill and just bail immediately because I think they're terrified to use their ults at this point. Every ult is just getting taken, right? There's been no black holes used. Irving's just so scared to use it versus Planet. And you can see why. I mean, Planet on fire on this Rubick.
They've got to find him first.
Just ain't easy.
Nope. And for LGD, a very simple solution. Send in your big baddies to run on in and start killing people. Make sure that Rubick's protected.
Yeah, just send the Undying in. Who cares if Innocence dies? If he gets Tombstone down, job's done, gets Vision of the fight, and then the three bruisers go in and,
Irving. Irving, he's found. Planet got him. Oh, man.
How does he keep finding him?
Did he just walk through the trees? He was like, he's down here, surely.
The Eidolons are kind of killing Planet, but... Shiro turns into the Enigma as well, tries to cut the trees. Three Midnight Pulses.
Wow.
I love when Rubick and Morphling are on the same team.
Yeah.
Radiant's top tower. It's like you have to be. You're playing versus Mars, and Mars gets a spear, and then there's two more spears that fly out as well.
Jesus.
All these funny little combos you can do.
8,000 gold lead, where it's been sitting consistently. But everybody from IG heading on down here now to try and find Jianyu. Do they dare go for this kill?
He's so tanky. He's got Halberd.
Yeah, it looks like they're just wanting to take over the triangle so that way Ursa can farm some more.
Yeah, it's just scary to set up any of these plays around the towers because it feels like PSG.LGD, they never, at this point in the game, of course, they don't really have to use TPs ever.
Yeah.
So they always have TPs to just back up. So if they do go for the Centaur, they'll probably get like four wiped right afterwards.
Smoke up has five. Smoke immediately broken. Good blink away. Paulison gets out of harm's way.
Bonked planet a little bit backwards too.
And you see QYQX spams out the wave. Starts running out of there. And LGD kind of being pulled around the map a little bit. It does sort of beg the question of, what's the eventual end goal for this? But it is definitely trying to get into their next set of items at the very least.
Yeah, just continue controlling the map.
BKB Irving.
All right. Step one, kind of. Still has to find the Rubik, and then also... just has to find the Rubik.
Yeah.
And then get the Enigma and get the Lincolns pretty much so that he can have a little bit more of a safety net, but
right.
Still not easy. Let's see what they can do though. They're feeling confident. Basher also finished on Emo. See what they find.
They are fairly grouped together right now as LGD, and the call is to head right into the area where they're at.
They seem to know this. Look at the positioning. Undying checking one ramp, Primal Beast checking the other.
Paulison up front, nothing to say. They run into him. BKB out. Emo bashes, connects, gets the enrage off, and Pulverize not doing a ton. The BKB, the runaway. Still waiting. Irving on the low ground there, and a toss trying to break any blink daggers that they might have.
Throws a zombie at him.
Yeah.
That looked. I was like, what the hell did he toss? It was a zombie. That looked pretty funny. That's BKB from Primal Beast, BKB from Ursa, and Tombstone, I guess, and Stampede. Those are the three big things used.
Okay.
Ooh, now Planet has an Aeon Disc, so gets harder and harder. He also found a headband about 3 or 4 minutes ago, so distance of this Rubik. He's going to be playing so far back. And he also just has very far increased range to be able to steal these spells, too.
That Midnight Pulse can be kind of an interesting little addition, too. Oh my god, can you imagine if Enigma Black Holes and then Planet Midnight Pulses and then Steals Black Hole?
It could happen. It could absolutely happen.
Oh jeez.
Shiro, I saw he had Silver Edge queued up. I didn't really see the big reason why. He just has Shadow Blade now for now and then goes back for Satanic. I like that he just goes for finishing Satanic instead. Just a bit more survivable.
Again, all it takes is one big fight. If they can win a big one this would be huge. Gets the four staff away. Why? Taking a lot of damage here. Emo on top of him. Gets the silence out from that Mindbreaker. Tombstone down.
Shiro's
back away. Avatoss onto four. Butt turn. BKB Black Hole.
It's a big
one. The control is there. They've got more than enough damage. Stolen Black Hole. Spear away. Planet ready to turn this one. The big stomp in and the Black Hole countered onto two. Is it going to be enough for those kills? It certainly will. But Emo runs on in. Takes down Y. Triple kill for Emo.
And Roche. It's
in
up.
The end, this is a huge win for IG.
Great positioning from them. Shiro, he gets a four-man avalanche, but nobody else is there to back him up. Primal Beast got nothing offed. They completely controlled and killed off both those cores with the Black Hole. Irving comes in clutch. Planet not in range to be able to get that steal in time.
And I think that was the first Black Hole of the game, if I'm not mistaken.
I believe it was.
See how far back Planet was, and then, of course, if he's that far away, good recognition by Irving that he can't get in time.
Yeah, the dust jumping in catches the Centaur inside of there. Planet actually had to blink backwards to jump out of that Mars arena. Now a huge window. Really nicely done from IG.
I mean, he still steals Black Hole.
Sure.
But it wasn't onto Emo.
Exactly. Emo's able to run in, clean up the fight. All right, IG.
Yes!
I mean, it's a the dream fight, really.
Dude, that was awesome.
Taking out both cores, both of those big tanky cores, the Morphling and the Primal Beast, before they're able to do much of anything.
Well, Black Hole is still online for Rubick. They weren't able to kill Planet. Mm-hmm. So that's got to be a key hunting ground right now because, I mean, for both teams, right?
Full Abyssal for Ursa. They have Refresher Shard on Irving, and he's close to his Lincolns as well, too. So fights maybe looking a little bit easier now for IG. They've found a huge window in this game.
I honestly wonder if, like, you just maybe even want to wait out the fight until that you know that Black Hole is gone. You know what I mean? Like, it's a long duration to wait, but I don't know. It's always scary when going into the fight and they have that ability. Particularly on a Rubick with that crazy type of range he has.
They just have to be it's positioning, right? It's patience of positioning is... Now that is like literally the best possible place that they could have fought right there.
Yeah.
Up on the high ground, LGD on the low ground, gets caught like kind of awkwardly where the fight begins onto the Undying.
Well, I mean like trying to wait out the fight right now and say
instead
of like... IG just like chill for a little bit. No, even with the Aegis, like...
They'd have to, like, kind of sit in base, because, you know, PSG.LGD, they want to use it, right?
They're
like, that was a one-off. We made a total... We completely botched the fight. They still want to look to fight, even though they're into this Aegis.
And Planet, the one that's leading the charge with the wards. Paulison is there with an Invis rune. Oh...
They see Irving.
They find him. Big jump with the BKB. Planet there. They can break it, though, if they want, but looks like they're just going to let that kill happen. Okay, so they let Irving die. Emo, he is still back here and going to TP out. So using Black Hole solo on the Enigma, that's not too bad.
I think PSG.LGD is still happy with it, right?
Oh, yeah.
They're just looking to just get any type of kill that they can. Because I think they still feel stronger in the fights, just positioning all the importance. They can't get stacked up on the two cores. Morphling and Primal Beast can't get Black Holed when the Rubick's not there to get the steal. So they're happy with that. Downtime is not too long either. It's 100 seconds.
Could see that.
If he can steal it again.
Right there, Rubick is queuing up the BKB himself. Dude. This has the makings of a pretty freaking epic late game fights here, depending on what happens.
Abyssal
Blade finds him there to start, but finally turns, pops the BKB, pulverized, but the Enrage was ready. Stolen Avalanche, so that's what they're working with now.
Back up to a 6k lead there for PSG.LGD. IG can still see the possibilities of them being able to fight. Irving still a bit away from Lincolns, but it feels like perhaps they still just want to fight without it. Because he does have his Black Hole available with BKB. Maybe they can look to force something. A minute and a half left on Aegis.
Yeah, it's sort of a tough one, right? Because, you know, he's going to sort of not have buyback for this if he does go for that full Lincolns. And, what, 400 gold away? Pretty freaking close.
He's an emo. Don't take my creeps.
Get out of here.
Go away. Thank you.
Okay, he's going to get these ones most likely.
Yeah, they've got a bounty rune, so it should be pretty close to him having finished up. Okay. So I guess they can just finish up that Lincolns and then perhaps look for that fight. But that does mean it's just likely a timeout before that battle does happen. 50 seconds.
So the only other, I mean, there's nothing else that pierces BKB that he has to worry about right now, right? I don't think so on Enigma.
No, I'm trying to think about any like steel plays or anything. Like, no, he should be fine.
Okay. The only other thing could be just like dying to Morphling if his positioning is a little bit off or something.
Yeah, I guess eventually it will be the 25 on Primal Beast if he gets gets like some cast range.
Right.
Then perhaps maybe they can like break it with the Rubick and he can catch. That's like, you know, that's asking a lot, of course, but.
Totally. Conceivably possible.
Conceivably possible, exactly. On paper, as we like to say, right? That's everyone's favorite term, so I think in Dota. On paper and.
Dude, nobody does anything on paper anymore either. It's like.
That's actually quite true, right?
Yeah. The hell.
It's a good saying, though.
Yeah. Ward in the base. This one, not known about.
It's a big, especially when you have Tiny, it's a big one. And they did take the gem earlier.
Ooh.
Oh.
Planet.
That's switch up on Shiro as well. He's got a Hex.
Okay.
More and more carries lately, buying the Hex.
Showing the value of it.
Yeah. Versus Ursa, it's always going to be very strong. If you get it on the pre-BKB, he's just going to die.
Well, LGD now know Aegis is gone, mm-hmm. so they're going to smoke out and try and take the route through their own jungle, it looks like. And they've sort of been nursing this lead, 5K, roughly about where it was before. In terms of, like, you know, where the teams are sitting, would you still be giving the edge right now to LGD, you think?
A lot to execution, honestly. It's yeah. all going to be up to Irving, how much he's going to be able to make happen with these black holes. But vision, so important.
Walk right up the hill. They spot it right at the start. Everybody's grouped together. Shiro's just to the outside, though. It's a little bit scary. Where do they want to go?
I think Planet is now playing a lot more confident with how he's going to be holding his Blink Dagger. I think it's Dust's job. It's Dust and Emo's kind of job to, mostly Dust, to get this Rubick, try to just mess with him so he's not able to actually steal the black hole. So a lot of, like, simultaneous initiation for IG.
Well, with the Lincolns now, though, it's not going to be as much of an issue, right? Like, that should be able to deal with it.
Should be able to, yeah. It still is, like, yeah, 4 second cooldown on spell steal, so.
Yeah.
If he can,
true.
Like, initially break it and then they have an opportunity, you know.
He sees him before he gets out there, true.
Yeah. It's I think this whole game is now going to be determined on, like, vision in those and jumps.
Obviously, not many vision heroes in this game. The main one is that Undying with the Tombstone.
Mm-hmm.
Given that full vision in nighttime as well as in daytime. Zombies see everything.
They do.
And down bottom, they're going to try and push in the wave a little bit with these Eidolons, get some counter pressure going. A minute until Roche is capable of respawning, that next one's going to have everything on it.
It's initiation. Who can get that next Roche? So if LGD is able to control this area and IG is not able to kind of get this area back for themselves, then that could be disastrous, really, for IG.
Jagir picked up these neutrals.
Ooh. That could be a nice one for the Enigma. I think you give that to Irving immediately.
He passed it over.
Cooldown reduction's great and all, but as we were saying, positioning is everything.
And for LGD, I mean, it feels like it's still very much on Shiro just to sort of take the fights that he wants to in a successful way and, you know, find the hex, I guess, on the Ursa when Enrage is down. Or is he going to just try and, like, blow up these other supports?
Probably mostly the Ursa, or just a quick, if they get vision, right? Quick yeah. initiation, pop that Enigma if they can actually get on top of him.
Double catapult wave.
Man, it's going to start hitting this tower pretty hard. They have Eidolons too.
Yeah, this is needing to be dealt with. And IG, they are heading back up towards the area where Roche is. It's a long respawn, 2 minutes.
This tower is...
It's going down if they're not careful.
It's going to drop pretty soon. Like, these Eidolons tanking for catapult, and then the next wave is coming. Irving's able to keep those catapults alive. Tower might just fall. Looks like one of them will survive at the least. So, yeah, PSG.LGD, they're maybe going to have to react to this.
Yeah. It looks like it's going
to... It's okay.
Yeah.
All right. Opposite sides having the same thing kind of happen. They had the double catapult. So
right.
They did the math. They knew.
Smoke. Who they find in. Illusions being sent out by the Morph. And back bottom again, or just the long way around.
Trying to get the long wrap around. But yeah, they know that this ward is here. So not wanting to walk right into this vision.
Okay.
Oop, ward placed, they know. LGD knows the exact positioning now of IG. They counter smoke. He's waiting with the tombstone. Look at Y.
Yep. Right smoke. Up there. Catches him. Dust, he's already got. And he's dead. Didn't get it down. Now, buys back.
Glint Force Staff in the black hole onto both of them. Stolen black hole. Tries to turn it, but it's already too late. The Avatoss, they got Planet under control.
Second round, the charm taking down Shiro, but is it going to be enough damage? Planet able to get away a little bit there. And the control is enough to kill, nothing to say, but they managed to find that Rubick and bring him down. Another buyback.
Holy, I mean, all of PSG.LGD, they know this is the fight that determines the game. The Roche could be up, still not there, 20 seconds.
Oh,
and now
man.
There's no black holes.
Ooh, crazy, crazy.
Four buybacks.
I mean, that was so much damage dealt. And Roche about to respawn. Do IG just feel like now they can't go and fight it? I guess that's the case.
Without having any black holes available, without having any arena as well, Yeah, this Roche now, it's going to go PSG-LGD's favor.
I mean, that was a lot of buybacks used, though. Yeah. Four buybacks. They have to get the value out of this here.
They're going to have a window, 100 seconds. So PSG-LGD, do they take the risky kind of play to smoke and look for a battle, or smoke and just look too straight to go for a push? See which one it's going to be.
Such a tough question right now, which way they want to go with it.
And they're giving it to Rubick. Okay, now it's... I mean, now it's kind of scary.
Okay. So two spells stolen.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I'm not sure. What to break it down for me. Like, I guess now you have a window where you can try and run in and actually make the fight happen. But with no buybacks, you can just straight up lose the game if you lose a fight.
It's a very risky position for the side of PSG-LGD. They have to be very careful the next way they take the fight. They give the Primal Beast the Aegis, though. They know that Shiro, they're probably telling him, okay, you're going to have to be the one that holds buyback. Primal Beast can go in and die once and then reset. 40 seconds until that black hole does come up. And the other thing is, too, that was the refresher shard they held from way earlier. So that's why it did go so successful that they did still have that on Irving. This time around, he's not going to have that second round of black hole.
Yeah, only the one. Trying to build into the refresher, but he's still a ways away from it.
I think this is one of the better games that we've gotten in China. This is super close, and I don't think many people expected it with the way that PSG-LGD had that lead.
Yeah, I think a testament to how much IG has grown over the duration of this DPC season. Like, even in this little bit, they are looking so much better than they did in that first series that we watched of theirs.
Yeah. Emo, 25, getting close to being maxed out. Finished up an MKB just before as well. The damage, he'll be able to just eat right through that Morphling if he sticks on Miz. We've seen a few times, and yeah, they're looking for it. Black hole's back up.
They know that this could be the win. This could be the one that they get there. And on the bottom side of the map, they're going for the long wraparound. LGD, Shiro.
They seem to know.
Thinking they're in the area. Spot, nothing to say. Spot Shiro right away on top of him with the Abyssal Blade. He didn't get it off. Does he have enough to survive through it, though? Thinks about it. Turns in. Black hole.
It's nothing.
Has to cast another thing. Well, they already have killed off the Morphling, but he buys back now. It's only stolen Malifus. Emo dies to nothing to say.
Oh.
And it's too much damage. Black hole didn't do a thing.
He literally was on nobody. I think they didn't really, you know, this is the buyback kind of play thing that you play around. Shiro, he runs in first to force it. It didn't actually even hit him. He dies before it even clips onto him. But
I think they were just wanting to make sure they got that Morphling kill, and he ended up, you know, coming out of the spear and still dying. Granted now, that's five buybacks used, but with no black hole, I mean, how much can LGD do? I feel like they have to get something here, though. Let's take a look at this again.
They're going to go for a push for sure with those being down. Yeah, it's a great jump. I mean, Emo, he gets the full cleanup. But then Irving, yeah, a bit of a whiff there. And then the positioning's really awkward for them. Tombstone on high ground. They have full vision, full everything of the fight, really, with that buyback from Shiro. Yeah, high ground push. Shiro now.
See if they decide how much they decide to give up.
There's nothing on IG. There's no black hole. There's no Marzolt. Neither of them.
Yeah, this is so hard to make any type of a counterplay happen. And again, one lane of Rax already dead. They're going to pop the glyph on the second as they'll try and do whatever stall tactics they possibly can. Avalanche, throw it out. And LGD going to respect the respawns.
They are starting to get, you know, those buybacks. It's been about 3 minutes, so 3 minutes left on them. They're going to back up, play it a little bit careful.
I mean, this is almost feeling like a Hail Mary moment, though, for IG, right? Like, you know that none of them have buybacks for a little while longer. Do you just go for it all and try and find a kill here? Because if you win a fight, you win the game.
They need 40 seconds.
Yeah.
40 seconds for Irving. Dust has about 50 seconds for double. So maybe you just wait the minute before you look to make that big play.
Scotty Dunn on Morph. A 6,000 gold lead.
Nothing to say. His Aegis is going to wear out. So this could be a window where they can even find the Primal Beast in the front lines. He wants to ideally break the smokes, but if Aegis wears off and they kill him, then it could just be a 4v5 fight immediately.
Anybody dies, and it is such a big boon for IG here.
They have a full hex on the Tiny. Also, Polison if he wants to purchase it.
Wow.
Everyone's starting to pick up quite a bit of items here. QIQX also has an Aghanim's, but looks like they're all just saving buybacks, so they want to have that. Because they all should have it. Yeah, all five do have it available on the side of IG, so.
Yeah, they get a Lincoln's now on the Ursa.
Okay. They can protect Irving a little more.
Yeah.
Throw double Lincoln's on him. Irving very close to his refresher as well, too.
And that Hex is bought out.
Okay, so no buyback then.
No, still has it.
He still has it. Oh, wow. He's super rich.
He's crazy farming.
EHOME,
everybody
though.
Is.
EHOME does not.
Yeah.
EHOME spent.
Battle Fury in the backpack. It's all about the battle. And this team is going to be furious if he dies.
Yeah. LGD is they're playing it patient, though. Buybacks coming back up 1 minute. 4 minutes, of course, for the Morphling, though. So he's the one. Shiro still has to be very careful. And for IG, they should be able to recognize all in the Morphling. And here we go. They've got everything back up.
Yeah, I guess that's a good point, too, is that with the other ones coming close on timing, it's probably better just to sort of zero in on that morph as the main one to go for.
Right now, they have this 60-second window. If they can catch, could just be the deciding factor for them. They also have this toss requires no target, which sometimes just catches people off guard, too. If they get a base ward, they get a toss out of somebody. Could be huge from Polison.
Polison.
Spotted, he knows, yeah.
Drops down a ward and immediately realizes, dude, can you imagine?
Like, he could do crazy stuff. Polison can blink if he gets that high ground vision, blink Hex, toss the Morphling out, and then Morphling can't shift and actually just dies, so.
That's
not
going
to be the case, though.
DD spawns bottom. LGD do spot it. As Centaur is running out along the top lane there. Don't know if he was scouted or not.
Buybacks back in 10. Now they're just short a little bit of gold. 500 right. On Centaur, 300 on Rubick.
It definitely feels like with IG now in their positioning, we're going to be getting to another Roche.
Game is getting complicated, it feels like, for PSG LGD, just because so many rounds of these ultimates are just going to constantly be available for the side of IG.
You can see 56-44.
It's so close.
It's up in the air. Oop.
Almost finding the Centaur top. The DD, it's still bottom. Shiro, he's going to get eyes of it.
Yeah, that's a nice win for him. And just running around with that ninja's gear, can't get scouted.
One of the best heroes in the game to get DD since you're just raw stats.
Yeah, that's like what, 780? It's pretty big.
Still 100 short on those buybacks on Rubick and Centaur. If they can get like one or two kills, then they'll be fine for it. All right, let's see how it goes. Into the high ground they go.
Dude, waveform attacks targets is pretty good for this, but the jump in, EHOME, he gets the enrage off in time. Trying to find one. Where do
black
they hold?
Find a black hole. It's onto him. EHOME, he's going to get on top, but he's getting blocked by Eidolons. He's trying to find the finish, and they get it. 2 minutes on the sideline. No Morphling.
And they've got another, black hole.
Oh, my God. The double. They drop it. Tries to BKB and get out of there, and it looks like he's going to. EHOME chasing. Hunting wants to find a bash. The pushback, not bad
what
at all. And the spear is connecting. Now they lock together.
He's got a blink.
And gets out. So 30 seconds on Roche, but no Morphling. He can't be in this fight.
Perfect recognition from Irving. They saw that the Rubick was a bit far away. He's actually able to just throw that black hole. It was a moment there when they didn't have detection. The Sapphire actually wasn't close enough. So they're like, wait, he's in the black hole. I know it, but I can't hit him. And then, yeah, QIQX gets in range.
I thought he was getting blocked by Eidolons, the wall of them that was there.
It looked like it as well, yeah.
That's so crazy.
Eidolon's scouting the Roche. They're going to know it's up immediately. They're going to be able to get that one as well. IG. Starting to do it here.
Bouncing back and forth on the gold lead. It doesn't really matter because the big win here is going to be a huge amount of net worth in that Aghanim Scepter and then that second life. I'm not even sure who they want to give it to. I guess Ursa seems to be a pretty good bet.
Probably, yeah. I'd say just give them most of those items. Aegis and Eggs.
Yeah, he gets there.
Yeah. They'll give Irving that next refresher, of course. We do know that we cannot stack them, though. Can't refresh and refresh. I know there was a moment where you could use the shard and then the orb afterwards, after they patched it, but pretty sure that was fixed. So he's going to pass it away. He's going to give it to the Ursa as well.
Cheese on the Enigma. Emo having trouble trying to juggle all of his items right now.
Yeah. So maybe I have to sell this battle. Here he is. 10,000 gold in his backpack.
That's crazy. Yeah, it might be time to get rid of that.
Might be time to get rid of one of those soon. He still has growth, though. He still has like bots, too, that he can buy and stuff like that. But
yeah, he's going for the Swift Blink. I think he probably sells it here.
Yeah. Let's see what he does get rid of. Nope.
Yeah. He's attached.
All right, PSG.LGD. Now they have every buyback ready. So Shiro, even though he was brought down before, does have it. And they also pass. I was wondering why Shiro was holding the Refresher Shard. I know he has literally six activatable items, but nothing to say is, like, you know, he has this really valuable position where he can just get this like double pulverize and just change the entire tides of the fight.
Huh. Damage there changed to pure two. Didn't even know about that one. But regardless, you're seeing one of the other queued up items that can maybe save the day here, the Wind Waker. Dude, if we're getting to Wind Waker gaming.
Oh, I love it. Please.
That I don't even know what to say anymore at that point. We're going to be seeing some crazy stuff.
Would you say that you have nothing to say?
God.
I'm so sorry.
You know what it was? It was T. We came over here and he did that awful pun to start this. It's all his fault. Unbelievable.
Yep.
We love it.
Yep. All right. Five buybacks. Four on the other side. They did get Polison to use his before, but now he's got Aeon Disc, so a little more coverage. PSG.LGD, yeah. They're very scared to step outside. Double black holes at the ready.
Dude, everybody's so afraid to move anywhere. They're so scared. Which, fair enough, you know? It makes sense. It's like, you get to these points in the game, and it's like, what is the proper initiation? And you kind of get an idea for it when you're out in the open, but then now you're in the lead and you need to figure out how to break high ground as IG. And it's like, what's the protocol for that? I mean,
a good fight.
Okay.
That's probably going to be the case. Just trying to get this really successful fight. And I mean, I think this ninja gear is honestly like pretty game winning. Irving just constantly smoked. They're never able to find him to get the jump on him. And ooh, top dust.
Wants to find him. Find him.
Can't quite. DP.
It's one of those moments where you expect like a blind blink and suddenly you get him. Innocence. Why?
He is on a journey.
He's just running around with a gem. He stole the ninja gear. It's pretty cool.
That would be pretty amazing if he somehow did do that.
Well, no, he has his own.
I know.
Gotcha.
I meant if he stole, right? But he just looks like he's just like trying to get some information with it, and then swapping a telescope for the fights.
He's stealing the outpost.
Sneaky.
That's crazy.
Oh, it's an arcane rune. This could be a dictator to allow them to fight for Irving.
Okay. Universe, he takes it.
He just has 1:30 left, so maybe wanting to try to take some type of advantage with it.
Dust has bots. He also has the unassembled Aeon Disc ready to go.
Fights are going to be wild. Polison thinks about it.
Yeah, and they get the D ward right there. They realize that it was going on.
Is that his job with the ninja gear?
Dude, that's crazy.
I'm just taking outposts, guys.
Don't worry. I'm on the job.
That's actually pretty funny. Is he going to cut a wave too? He is.
Why not?
All right. Well, Tombstone's probably going to die. One more gay. Oh, it's a close one. The battle. Okay, they get it. Pushed out top. Jump.
Abyssal already there. Spear misses. Oh, but second round, it's enough for the kill. Okay. They take down, nothing to say. Obviously has buyback.
Didn't have to commit the black hole, though. It's just the first set of Verino there from the Mars. Oh, and now Mars 25 as well. So extra regen inside of his ult. He's got it online.
And has everything ready to go, but no refresher.
And no wave, as we did see. You know, top wave, it was taken out from that tombstone. Mid wave is going to be the big one that they need. Polison, he looks like he's pinging, expecting someone to cut it.
And they have a wave pushing into their base, actually, that they haven't been able to deal with.
Yeah, the tier 4 was taken out earlier from it.
Jumps in. Abyssal finds him. Hex, but... Aeon Disc in. That is an illusion, sir.
Okay,
Lincoln
he covered.
Sphere popped. And that's Malifus stolen.
He covered it nicely. Black Hole, then immediately Malifus.
Dude, they're tier 4s. They have to get back. Yeah, they're back there now.
Okay, and Aegis does get reclaimed. So now, PSG.LGD. Very patient also. Look at nothing to say. Held his buyback when they dove high ground. So
yeah.
Very, very patient this game.
Octarine Core done for the Enigma. This is the type of game that could definitely just end in one bad fight.
Yep.
And it also could go on for like another hour, I feel like.
Absolutely. We do have those neutral items very soon, though. We're
That's true.
We haven't gotten any for us.
No.
That usually means that the game's going to end right before it happens.
I mean, that's what happened yesterday. We had one where it ended at 60 minutes, I think.
I think it was like 60:04. Right?
Yeah.
It was literally as the 60-minute mark happened, the game ended.
Oh, and there it is. This is another way to end the game. The Eidolons!
He has hit 25.
Dude, look at him. Look at him go. All right, well, Fade Bolt's pretty good against him.
Tower
but
drops.
They take it down.
Jump.
Safe's push. Y gets out of there. Oh, Tombstone
Dust.
Down.
That's Dust's second BKB.
Hmm.
Now going to be a lot more reluctant to go in.
60 seconds until refresh orbs back up again.
60 seconds till refresher, or 60 seconds till refresher, 60 seconds till those items.
Wait, did they refresh on the Enigma?
He immediately did, yeah.
Okay, got it.
GD trapped in the base for quite some time now.
Yeah. They haven't really been able to get out there, and IG building up their lead 14k now. They do have to get back and again defend their base.
Yeah, they're pinging it already. They're like, this bottom lane, it's starting to get pretty annoying.
Yeah. And with 59 minutes in, we are just about to get into those tier 5 neutrals. LGD, I mean, this is always a tough situation too. Do you want to try and go out, send somebody on like a little mission to get some items yourself? Are they trying to take a fight right now?
They saw the Mars bottom. It looks like they want to maybe set up for him.
Oh, he almost broke that smoke.
So close.
QYQX heading in here.
So close. EMO.
And EMO finds him.
He knows.
Planet right on top of him. Gets the lift, but Abyssal is there. Force Staff tries to get out. Stomp. Irving right on top. Finding Planet. He's dead. Can they get out with everybody else now? Nothing to say. TPing. And it looks like they will manage to get out with everybody else.
What a read by IG. They know that perhaps they're going to set up for this Mars on bottom. EMO just jumps right in. They find the Rubick as well, the ideal target.
And immediately they're running into the triangle here.
They see the Centaur pushing up far. They're setting up for him already. They have that side ward, the Tinker ward, as we call it.
Oh, trying to TP out. And
they
there it is. The Hex comes out in time. And they will find this Centaur. EMO chasing in and getting him there. Aeon Disc will not keep alive at Cent.
60 minutes. Shiro probably going to start running to some neutrals to find them. First one, it will be found, the Book of the Dead. Buyback forced from the Centaur. They're holding out the planet's buyback as long as possible, though.
It's a Stygian Desolator on the Ursa.
Oh.
So he has that one now. And sixth Rosh is up. Shiro.
Giant's Ring.
Oh, man.
Also a big one, too, for the Mars.
Yeah, Shiro's just going out to go farm him. He knows he needs to get him.
They have a ward on it, though. They're preemptively prepped for the 60-minute mark, so they do see the Morphling.
Ooh, this is a big play. He's completely alone here. Shiro goes invis.
Does he
on
know?
Top of the ward. No,
oh my God,
he doesn't
they're
know.
They're going to be able to catch him with this.
The jump in, and the Hex is out. The BKB, the black hole. Don't spear that guy too far away, but they get the finish.
IG, the preparation for the 60-minute mark. Knowing
Dude, they
that
knew.
They know LGD's going to go for some type of fancy play to try to find him.
Unreal.
Instant refresh, looking for the next one.
With an arcane rune. They are running down lanes. They've got Aegis on Ursa. The Aghanim Scepter gets picked up by QYQX, so he can go for some toss-in plays or jump in to save people.
All smoked in the back line, too. 31,000 lead.
Ready to run in. They've got that shard on Irving, ready to go. Eidolon spawn, send him on in to take down that tombstone, but Fadebolt does some pretty good damage. And it looks like they're going to have to wait out that tombstone, trying to not use the buyback on the Morphling if they can hold it.
Olison's ready to go in again.
They jump, they find him. Do a ton of damage there. Spear connects, controls, and dead. Stolen toss, that's not going to do enough. Centaur jumps in for the stomp. They jump out.
They full reset on the buybacks.
Nothing to say. Has to be careful about this one. He manages to escape from that.
Planet. Looks in pretty aggressively. Trying to find Irving. Shiro.
Went forward pretty far. Thought he had Irving. Wasn't the case. He's still good with 20 seconds left. until these got double black hole again.
Yep. They're just trying to find him, but he's never giving them the opportunity. Bottom is pushing in again. Dust has to back up and take control of that.
This is one of the best Enigma performances I've seen in a long time. He had so many counters against him.
Yeah, he seems to have, after that top one, he seems to have always been able to find that Morphling or the Primal Beast. And I think we're going to start getting to points where people can't actually spend their gold. Emo, 12,000 gold.
Yeah.
Doesn't even have Moonshard. Doesn't care for it. Doesn't need it.
He's got what he needs.
He's almost maxed on attack speed anyway. Stun.
Hex up an Eidolon.
Something to say. Hex.
Toss out. There we go. Special delivery. Courtesy of Tiny. BKB is there with the Pulverize. Turn now onto Dust. Second Pulverize. It's not doing enough damage. Fallen Sky to interrupt. Crazy things are happening in this game.
They just don't seem to have the damage at all.
No.
Shiro's never able to really stand his ground and hit people because of the fear of these black holes. IG, just perfectly set up.
Emo moves on in. Does not have Battle Fury in inventory at the moment, but does a good chunk of damage there, taking down these creeps. Again, the big worry that you always have to have in the back of your head for IG is this bottom lane.
Yeah,
is
the
there
back door.
Any chance we could see like a Morphling going for an all-in at some point? Maybe even buying a Rapier or what have you.
It feels like that actually might be the only chance that PSG.LGD has to win this game now at this point. They can't win fights,
no.
So they're going to have to do something crazy to try to have an opportunity.
Shiro is trying to buy the Rapier right now. And in the meantime, see the wave being pushed in up top here.
Abyssal dropped here. Oh, okay. Dust? Maybe they set up the gank here on him, Shiro. And why?
I don't know if they do enough damage, though.
Should be able to.
Hex? Okay, you're right. Definitely did. They had enough damage.
Yeah.
So you suggest them not doing enough, but they find the kill onto Dust.
Yeah, finally, it's not them just being CC'd the entire battle.
Emo, he catches them in the Fallen Sky!
What?
Emo, I mean, that's 120 seconds. Bars buyback. They can look dead.
Immediately, they go on in for this one. No Centaur here. Stolen Overpower. That one's not going to be good enough. The melee Raxes are falling. They're throwing Eidolons in. Giant Tiny. Giant support Tiny. Find Why You Smile. He's still fine, though. Stolen Avalanche. Shiro rolls through. Kisses raining down from on high. Just trying to cover the area. Get that vision.
Raxes are dying.
Another one falling. Do they go for any more now? Dust does not have buyback, and this Aegis is going to expire in 40. 80 seconds still without Centaur. You got to imagine that this
bottom
is going to be the place they go.
The Book of the Dead is starting to shove the wave in pretty hard. Double catapult wave for the side of LGD.
Close are they to the rest of this? They ended up not buying yet. I think the Rapier is
on the
courier coming back right now.
It's been spotted too. They pinged it immediately.
It's in vision. Rapier on courier. Head on in with Shiro. He's got it. Boots of travel.
Dust has to go back. They got Megas. All right, so now bottom wave, not going to be a problem for them. Those Mega Creeps will constantly be able to push out the waves. And IG looks to have done it. So as long as they don't throw this humongous fight, they don't give some type of black hole to this Cerubic in some type of weird fashion, this game should be in the bag for them.
I feel like I've seen so many of these games, though, where a team like has been working for this like final objective, and then suddenly everything falls out the wind, right? Like they're split up now, they're farming, somebody's gonna die, I can see it. Oh god.
Emo has to be cautious with his positioning.
Oh yeah.
I saw him for a second there, Shiro. We'll have to back away.
You can see with a 51,000 gold lead, it's 80%. What?
That's 20% is on, that's Planet right there. He's that one hero, so 20%, right, one out of five, something
I
like
see.
That, right? You can get that there.
Wow.
If he can get Black Hole still, it's seemingly pretty impossible, but
to be honest with you, I think IG can win without having to cast Black Hole again this game.
Probably, actually. Maybe that. It's so tough to tell your Enigma not to cast it, though.
I know.
He also has Seerstone, to be fair, so the distance that he's going to be casting Black Hole from is also quite crazy. And they're going to be able to constantly scout inside these fights.
All those neutrals. They have them all on the side of LGD. After the death on Shiro, they haven't been able to go out onto the map to secure the rest of them.
Yeah. IG has all five. Yep.
That's what I meant.
Yeah, they're stuck in the base for what feels like... It feels like for almost 15 minutes now, more.
No.
After these fights from IG, just recognizing who to get these black holes on. And IG. Still farming. Dust has to be careful, of course. He is the one that did use buyback. Doesn't want to overcommit too hard.
Oh, yeah. I wonder if they just wait for that.
Oh, we have 30 now, of course, on Ursa. So one of the... I mean, really, it's a really strong talent, but the other one's just too strong to take. Enrage now provides half benefit to all your allies in the radius.
Okay.
So inside the Mars Arena, inside like the areas of Black Hole and stuff like that, Emo is going to be able to protect his allies, too.
Interesting.
It's actually cool, too, because... Maybe if they can kill the Enigma, that's just gonna prevent the damage to even have to be able to kill the Enigma during Black Hole too.
Hmm.
Even though LGD hasn't been able to kill him anyway, but you know, you can.
Does it work on the shard as well? I assume it would. I don't see why it would, but it's only for like a second anyways.
I think it's only on the ult.
Okay. Smoke out as five. LGD.
There's a ward here. Dust is thinking about jumping.
There's many heroes in the area.
He's got bots too.
Tombstone, they're right on top of him. Look at the kisses come on down here. The black hole connects onto both. They are gone. Just like that.
They found another neutral item though. Did see LGD was looking to go find those in the meantime, but they do not have a primal beast now for 2 minutes.
Ex Machina is big, but I don't know if it's going to be big enough. You don't have it. You don't have this primal beast. You will have buyback back up in 50 seconds, but the tier 4 tower's being hit. They have one more chance. Planet.
Look at these Eidolons.
Planet with the Phalanx trying to protect his area. Not sure if it's going to be enough.
The throne.
The Fallen Sky. They're focusing it down. LGD, they have to fight right now, but there is not enough in the world to stop this damage from coming on out. IG, they jump on in. They're trying to find him, and the throne is going to fall as GG is called. IG, they managed to squeeze this one out. I can't believe it.
I cannot believe it. The way that they take these fights. Couple slip-ups from PSG.LGD after they were playing a near-perfect game, right? I think this game at some point was, 15-3? Something like that with an 8K gold lead. IG, they know the...